Good day, everyone. I'm here to showcase a complete true rookie card collection of Dallas Mavericks legend and recent Hall of Famer Dirk Nowitzki. I hope this will help anyone who's looking to start their own rookie card collection or those who are simply looking to know more about them. In my opinion, Dirk's rookie year cards are still relatively cheap, so it would be easy to start a collection. I've been collecting Dirk rookies on and off since the early 2000s, and you can find my collection in my Instagram page, Nowitzki Rookies. Dirk has 18 true rookie cards, recognized by both Beckett and PSA. When I say true rookies, these are his base cards from sets released during his rookie season. Inserts and parallels are not included, and I will be featuring those in a future video. So without further ado, let's get started. First up, we have Dirk's Topps number 154, which came from Topps Series 2 packs. This, I think, is his most common rookie card. As you can see, it's got a rather awkward photo of Dirk rebounding, printed on plain cardstock with only his name and the Topps logo in foil. On the back, there's a nice tidbit about Dirk leading his hometown team, the Würzburg X-Rays, to a championship. This card had no parallels. Back in the early 2000s, Beckett mistakenly listed an OP cheap parallel for this card, which caused some confusion with collectors. It was later confirmed that rookies were not given OP cheap parallels. Next on the list, we have his Finest number 234 from Finest Series 2 packs with player odds of 1 in 21 packs. It features Dirk yet again in an unflattering pose, but this time the presentation of the card is more interesting with the chromed out background. It comes with a Finest protective film. There's a nice tidbit here about his exploits in the 1998 Nike Hoop Summit, where he led a team of young international players to win against a team of young US-based players. He scored 33 points and 14 rebounds there. This has a confusing parallel, as collectors may assume that the no protector version is just the same as the base card, but with the protective film removed. However, the no protector version also has metallic foil on the back of the card, which sets it apart from the base. Overall, it has 3 parallels. Next up, we have his Flair Showcase Power Row 3 card, included in the Showtime subset as indicated here. The Showtime subset was the most common amongst the base subsets, and this card had player odds of 1 in 24 packs. This is one of Dirk's nicer true rookies, with both his full on-court action shot and the close-up decked out in refractor finish. Here's the back of the card. This card has a staggering 8 parallels, which is the most out of all his rookie cards. Up next, we have the Skybox Molten Metal number 35, included in the Metalsmith subset as indicated here. This card had player odds of 1 in 25 packs. Here we have another shot of Dirk mid-rebound amidst an emerald green background. The logo and text have got a nice refractor shimmer. As you can see, his jersey is not yet numbered, which may indicate that this shot might be from his earlier rookie photoshoots. Here's the back of the card. This card has only one parallel. This one's my absolute favorite among all of Dirk's true rookies. The Skybox EX Century number 68 had player odds of 1 in 45 packs. It's an amazingly designed acetate card with some pearlescent refractor on the background text and logo and a shot of Dirk posting up. The back of the card is fantastic as well. These guards are very sensitive to light, heat, and humidity and are prone to yellowing. Here's some copies that have yellowed back when I was still living in hot and humid tropical countries. If you have these acetate cards, I highly recommend keeping them out of direct sunlight and storing them in a cool, dry place. This card has 2 parallels. Next up is the Fleer Brilliance number 109 with player odds of 1 in 50 packs. As the name suggests, it has a mirror-like chrome finish with Dirk wearing an unnumbered jersey, sternly holding the ball. The back of the card is oriented horizontally and color matched to the player's team, so Dirk gets his Mavericks green here. The tidbit here also references his Monster Nike Hoop Summit game. This card has three parallels. The next card on our list is the Topps Chrome number 154, which some might mistake as a parallel of the Topps card I showed earlier. It has player odds of 1 in 54 packs. It has the same photo and design cues as the Topps number 154, but now with a solid chrome border, chrome finish, and an embossed photo of Dirk. The back is almost the same as the aforementioned card. It has only one parallel. Here's our first upper deck card on the list, the Ionix number 69 from the rookie-only electric subset. It has player odds of 1 in 80 packs. This is my favorite among his upper deck true rookies due to the funky late90s.com aesthetic and the blue and green hue that matches his team colors. Here's the back of the card, which is equally funky. This card has only one parallel. The next card on our list is the upper deck number 320 from the Rookie Watch subset of the MJ Access Series 2 packs. It has player odds of 1 in 88 packs. Not a huge fan of the rather unflattering photo they used here, but it must have been from an earlier rookie photoshoot, judging by the unnumbered jersey. I do quite like the hardwood background they've used here. The colors they've used for the rookie watch highlights are matched to team colors with blue for the Mavericks. Here's the back of the card. This card has two parallels. Coming in next is the upper deck Ovation number 79, which is the first mail-in card on our list. You needed to pull this number 79T redemption card from packs and mail it to upper deck to get this card. This is a very interesting pair of cards as it tells you a bit about Dirk's draft day history. It's a bit hard to see, but draft pick number 9 is written on it. You can also spot the Milwaukee Bucks logo here, which held the 9th pick at the time. Now, why would you get a Dirk card for this when he's been a Maverick for his entire career? Well, the short answer is that Don Nelson planned a 3-team draft day trade between the Mavericks, the Bucks, and the Suns. The Mavericks traded their 6th pick, Robert the Tractor Trailer, rest in peace, to the Bucks for both their 9th and 19th picks, Dirk and Pat Garrity. Garrity, along with Martin Morsep, Bubba Wells, and the rights to a first round draft pick, were then traded to the Suns for Steve Nash. So that's how the Mavericks acquired both Dirk and Steve back in 1998. The player odds for this redemption card is 1 in 90 packs. I would assume that not everyone had a chance to redeem this card, which may make it a bit scarcer. Both the redemption and mail-in cards have a nice basketball textured finish. This has a nice action shot of Dirk mid-dunk, which is also embossed and printed in metallic foil. Here's the back of the card. This has one parallel, which also had to be redeemed. Next up is the Bowman's Best number 109. With player odds of 1 in 100 packs. It's another cool chrome offering from Topps, featuring Dirk battling with Tom Gugliotto for a rebound, with Cedric Ceballos and Cliff Robinson unlooking. The back of the card is oriented horizontally, and we get here a nice side profile of Dirk and a nice reference to his German compatriot Detlef Schrem, who interestingly was also drafted by Dallas in 1985. Dirk also played against Detlef and the Supersonics during his very first NBA game on the 5th of February 1999. This card has two parallels. The next card on our list is the Ultra number 188 from the Rookie subset with player odds of 1 in 100 packs. This is a rather iconic rookie card as it features a pivotal point in Mavericks history. Dirk flew in from Germany to Dallas 4 days after he was drafted into the NBA, and Don Nelson presented him to the Mavericks community for the very first time. He didn't have a suit to wear for this press conference, so Don Nelson brought him to a custom tailor in Dallas, where this particular suit is from. Afterwards, Don Nelson hosted a barbecue for Dirk, Holger Geschwinder, and Steve Nash, along with some Maverick players and staff. He flew back to Germany that night and the rest is history. I'll put a link of that press conference below. Here's the back of the card, talking a bit about Dirk's international credentials. it has three parallels. Up next is the Upper Deck Encore number 122 from the Rookie Watch subset, with player odds of 1 in 116 packs. Some have mistaken this for a parallel of the Upper Deck number 320 due to the same design cues, but they are from two distinct sets. This is an improvement to the aforementioned card, with a nicer shot of Dirk dribbling the ball, and an added refractor finish on the hardwood background. The back is almost the same as the Upper Deck number 320, with the inclusion of the Encore text. This card has only one parallel. Another offering from Upper Deck is the Black Diamond number 92 from the Rookie Only Diamond Features subset. This card has a nice metallic and textured foil background in mosaic, which sort of reminds me of the clear metal cards. You also have a nice action shot of Dirk mid layup. The back of the card again mentions Detlef Schrempf. Notice that there's a lone diamond on the lower left. This card has three parallels, which had additional diamonds indicating scarcity. The next card on our list is the Skybox Premium number 255 from Series 2 packs, with player odds of 1 in 156 packs. This is one of the classier designed Dirk rookie cards with a painting-like feel to it. It has soft vignetting on the corners, soft blurred background, and an action shot of Dirk trailed by a blue-green aura. The aura here is matched to team colors. The back of the card is minimalistic yet looks fantastic. This card has only one parallel. The next card on our list is another mail-in card, the Stadium Club number 109. Cards number 101 to 120 of this set were the top 20 picks of the draft class and were inserted as redemptions in Series 1 packs. The player odds of this redemption card is 1 in 168 packs. Redeeming this card from tops would get you this card, a nice in-game shot of Dirk dunking with fellow European Arvydas Sabonis onlooking, and it has a nice foil finish. Here's the back of the card, which has a tidbit comparing Dirk to Larry Bird. This card has 6 parallels, including 4 one-of-one printing plates. Another base card came out of the Stadium Club Series 2 packs, this Stadium Club number 202. This was not a redemption card and can be normally pulled from packs. However, this is not considered a Dirk True Rookie, as it was the second instance of the player in the same set. Alright, so we're down to our last True Rookies, which are both serial numbered offerings from Upper Deck's premium SP line. The first is this gorgeous SP Authentic number 99 from the Rookie FX subset, limited to 3,500 copies. It may be a lot of copies by today's standards, but note that this card did not have any parallels. It's got a classy painting-like feel to it, with a matte background, with some subtle blue paint flecks, soft vignetting, and a glossy printed photo of Dirk. I wish they printed the dot matrix serial number on the back, as I personally think it ruins the overall aesthetic. The back of the card is nicely designed as well, and has a nice tidbit about Dirk's first win with the Mavericks on the 7th of February, 2 days after his NBA debut. The last of our true rookies is the SPX Finite number 219, and is limited to 2,500 copies. What's interesting about this card is that it was not inserted in SPX Finite boxes. The rookies in SPX Finite were inserted in 2-card rookie update packs that were distributed in Upper Deck Series 2 MJ Access boxes. I presume that since Upper Deck did not have any rookie content ready when they released the SPX Finite set, they just deferred the release of the rookie to a later released product. This is a nicely designed card with an emerald foil hue, a photo of young Dirk presumably from his pre-rookie days, and a bronze embossed SPX medallion recessed into the card. You've got the serial number on the back, as well as a bit of his draft day history. Notice here that they misspelled Nowitzki with an extra S. This card has 2 parallels. It is also important to note that these 2 cards have some historical significance, as these were the very first basketball base cards that were serial numbered, In previous years, only parallels and inserts were serial numbered. So that's it, folks. A deep dive into the German Wunderkind's 18 true rookie cards. Thank you for watching. I'll be making more videos about his rookie year inserts and parallels. If you've got any questions, please leave a comment below. Please like and subscribe, and I hope to see you soon.